since the Pitzer Center opened now nearly 3 years ago, in the fall quarter, I lead a percussion workshop in which a group of the graduate students in composition and I get to spend a very leisurely 10 weeks talking about a whole variety of aspects of percussion. We talk about percussion repertoire and orchestration. We talk about performance practice. And most of all, we workshop their ideas and try out whatever crazy notions they have or conservative notions they have about using percussion in their works. And I feel tremendously grateful to have this opportunity to be able to spend so much time with these fantastic composers, getting to know them through their work. So today's program is the culmination of that workshop, in which I'm delighted to be premiering these three works for solo percussion and one work for percussion trio. I would be extremely remiss if I didn't offer my specific gratitude to Sam Nichols, who devised this whole idea now 3 years ago, as well as to all of my colleagues in the composition area for their support of this project, and to Laurie Sam Martin, the chair of the department, for funding it. That's what it is. So, I think that Adam was going to say a little bit about your piece, is that right? No, oh, I'm sorry. I apologize. I was told there was a question about whether or not the composers wanted to say something about their pieces. And I was backstage and just asked the stage manager, and there was some sense that there was consensus that everyone was going to speak, and so I felt like I should say something. So that's why I'm talking right now. Otherwise, I would not at all. Well, allow me to introduce this piece. The first piece in the program is Matriarch by Adam Strawbridge. Should I introduce anybody else? Is anybody else talking?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Everybody else is?
Sure.
The formality of the event is extraordinary. I'm glad to hear that. Okay.
Thank you. Hi there, thanks for coming. I'll try to keep it short. I just wanted to say a few things. One thing to consider as you're listening to this piece, kind of driving force of it is an overarching considerations of freedom. Some of these are, you can think of these in broad ways or things more specifically, more broadly. For instance, ideas of self-determination and paradox of democracy in U.S. society, or more specifically, recent cultural shifts, recent cultural shift where we're finding more and more support with criminal justice reform and ending mass incarceration in the U.S., stuff like this. And this is realized musically in a number of sort of metaphorical layers. Primarily, the biggest element is how the piece is shaped, the structure, the way it's structured. It opens with, throughout, Chris is confined most of the time to certain parameters, whether with regard to range or timbre, gesture, stuff like this. And particularly in the opening, you'll find it's very through composed. Everything is scored out. I've given them very specific directions on how to realize the music. And as the piece unfolds, he's given more and more freedom throughout to make some choices on his own. And the crisis point culminates with a freely improvised cadenza, which realizes this idea of these ideas of overarching ideas of freedom as well. This is my second time being a part of this workshop. I just want to thank Chris. Very grateful. It's been a wonderful experience to have been a part of this. So thank you again.
piece. Joseph, may I welcome you to the microphone?
Hello, thank you all for being here. I want to say before this last piece, thank you so much to Chris. When I started this piece, I had a lot of really raw ideas. I'd been doing improvisations on the piano for every day the first quarter, and Chris really helped me shape them into a working piece. You'll see in a minute that there's a lot going on inside the piano, and it's really hard to see exactly what pitches are going on. So Chris helped me sort of work out a way that we could distinguish and actually write a piece that isn't focused on pitch, but is more focused on gesture, which is sort of where the title Rude Gestures comes from. It's sort of a play on words. So without further ado, thank you.
Thank you.